of the Lovely Literature Ladies. I'm Gabriella.
And I'm Annalise. And this week we will be discussing a very classic tale. It is known as the Canterbury Tales and is about 23 pilgrims on their journey to Canterbury. They all meet at a hotel and their host beckons them to each tell a story. Let's begin with the Franklin's Tale.
You may now kiss the bride.
Dorigen, I love you, but I know it is in vain. Take pity on me, my beloved Dorigen.
I never knew you felt this way about me, Arliss, but you have to understand that I will never be unfaithful to my husband. But you are so pitiful that I will agree to be your lover only if you can remove all the rocks from the coast of Brittany so that the ships can sail freely.
Okay.
My dear brother Aurelius, don't give up. I know a man who can help you. He's a magician in Orleans.
I will pay you £1,000 if you can take all the rocks off the coast of Brittany.
Deal.
Abracadabra.
Dorigen, I love you. Removed all the rocks off the coast of Brittany. Go see for yourself. Please, think about your choice. Think carefully. We'll be waiting in the garden.
I regret to say it, but you must keep your promise. I would rather die than see you fail to keep your promise. A promise is the highest thing you can ever hold on to.
I've thought about it, and I've talked to my husband about it, and I've decided to keep my promise with you.
You know, I realized that your husband would rather endure the shame of having an unfaithful wife than see you break your promise to me. And even though it means I will lose the love of my life, I release you from your debt.
Can I please have 2 years to pay off my £1,000 debt?
Were you satisfied with your work? I mean, did you get your lady?
No.
Well then, you didn't really get your end of the bargain, so consider our debt gone.
So tell me, would you have had the strength to give up Dorigen as Aurelius had?
Our next tale will be the Pardoner's Tale.
Hey look, there's an imp passing by. I wonder if I'd kill them.
Let's just ask someone.
Have you boys heard of he who they call Death?
No, never heard of him.
Well, he's killed a lot of people. Probably lives around these parts.
Wow, thanks for the info.
Let's all take an oath to find Death.
I agree. Find Death.
Hey, you over there, Mr. Death Spy. Would you happen to know where we can find Death?
Of course. He's over there in the grove.
Thanks, man.
Anytime, brother.
Oh, sick! Jackpot!
I don't know about you guys, but I say we just give up this hopeless search for Death and just take the money.
I agree, but we're gonna need some food first. Hey dude, why don't you get it? You're the youngest.
You wanted me that way. I'll be back.
We would both get a lot more money if we only had to split it between the two of us.
That's true, and it's not like we like that dude anyway.
Exactly. I think we should just kill him when he gets back with the food.
I totally agree. There's two of us and one of him. We can definitely get it.
Man, we really hit the jackpot finding those gold florins. But you know, I could get a lot more money if I didn't have those two losers with me.
Poison! Get your poison here! Poison!
Ding ding ding! Idea!
I'm gonna buy the poison, and then I'll poison my friends, and then I'll be rich.
Want some of this?
Oh yeah. Poison. I need that.
Any more?
Poison. Yeah, I need one more. Thank you very much, sir.
Time.
I'm gonna be rich.
What's up? Hey dude, how's your trip? You're back.
It's great, man, you know.
Oh no!
Good work, he brought us drinks to celebrate.
How thoughtful of him.
Yeah.
A toast to our good friends.
Would you have shared the money, or would you have succumbed to the greed and taken it all by killing your friends?
Let us move on to our next tale, The Wife of Bath.
What you did was horrible and you deserve to be beheaded.
I know what I did was wrong, but please don't let me die here.
Honey, can I decide this way?
Sure thing, sweetie.
Okay, you must tell me what a woman desires. You have a year and 1 day to give me this answer. You must promise to return.
I shall take on this quest to find the answer.
Hello? Will you tell me what a woman desires most?
Riches, my dearest, what I surely desire.
Hello?
What does a woman desire most?
Honor.
Hi.
What does a woman desire most?
A man filled with gaiety.
Oh, look, over there. She'll surely know.
There's no path here. Can I help you?
I'm surely dead unless I can find the answer to what a woman desires most.
Ah, I do know that, but you're going to have to do exactly as I say.
Okay.
All right, here goes.
Do you have your answer now?
What a woman desires most is power over her husband and lover.
Excuse me, do you remember our promise?
Indeed.
Well then, you must marry me, mister.
Fine.
Come on, let's go.
I hate having such an old and ugly wife.
Well, you made this choice, mister. Now I'll give you another one. You can either have me out old and ugly, but loyal to you for the rest of your life, or you can change and have a young girl who's pretty, who goes around and cheats on you.
I want you to choose.
I choose both.
Which option would you have chosen? The old lady who's loyal to you, or the young lady who cheats on you?
Good question.
Let us move on to our next tale, the Nun's Bruce tale.
Ah!
Are you okay, Chanticleer?
I just woke up from a very scary nightmare. Burning monster tried to kill me. It had, it was orange and had black tips on its feet. And its eyes glowed.
You probably just had a bad dream. You should cleanse your body with some herbs.
Thank you, Parlet, but sometimes dreams can help see your future. Oh look, the story I found. The story is about two men that went on a pilgrimage. They had to stay in different hotels overnight. The second one had a dream that his friend was calling for help and that he would be murdered in his sleep. He had this dream again, and by the third dream, his friend said that he was dead and not described how he died and where he found his body. The next day, the man found his friend in the dream.
Don't be afraid. I'm your friend, and you have a lovely singing voice. Will you please sing a song for me?
Of course I will. Oh no! A fox is stealing Chanticleer! Let's get him!
Wait, come back. Chanticleer, you have such a lovely singing voice.
No,
I promise I don't want to hurt you. Just come down and sing for me. Your feathers are so lovely in the sunlight. Just come down and sing for me with your beautiful voice.
No, I'm not letting you do that again. Do you think I'm stupid?
Gabriella, do you have any toxic friends like the fox?
What do you mean?
Oh, nothing. Just beware of false flattery. Your dress is lovely, by the way.
Thank you.
Let's move on to our next tale, the Miller's Tale.
Hi, Nicholas. What are you doing up at this late hour? Charting the star reading lab?
Oh, so the simple carpenter is also a detective, too. Yes, John. I'm just looking at the stars. You know, you have such a clear view here. Thanks for letting me stay here, by the way.
Of course. You make a fine tenant, especially since you keep your hands off my lovely young wife. Hi.
Sweet Allison, you are truly the most beautiful girl in all the world. Spend the night in my arms, or I shall surely die.
Ew, no, get off me, you creep.
Please?
Oh, all right, but we're gonna have to trick John.
Consider it done. What kind of cleric would I be if I couldn't trick a simple carpenter?
Wow. I'm in love with this girl. I must have her, and I know exactly how to get her.
Here's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna hide in my room for 2 days. Surely John will worry about me and he'll come up to check on me. When he does, I'll tell him I've had this grand revelation from God and then we'll use that to trick him. Here's what I'm gonna say.
Where is Nicholas? I haven't seen him anywhere.
I definitely do not know where he is.
Well, I'll go check on him.
Nick, are you all right?
No. I've seen something in the stars.
What is it?
There's gonna be a humongous flood next Monday. It's gonna be worse than Noah's flood. It'll make it look like a puddle.
What? What's gonna happen to all of us?
I don't know, but dude, I found a prophecy. It's okay, I know exactly what to do. So, you're gonna get 3 barrels. You're gonna put them up on the roof. And then me and you and Allison are gonna hide in them. So then we'll be protected from the flood. And then, once the water comes up, we'll just float around like being safety stuff. So yeah, you got it?
Yes, I got it. I'll do anything you say.
Okay, go.
Allison, oh Allison, please come out here and kiss me.
Okay.
Ew, a butt.
Oh, to think I ever loved her.
Show her, I won't show her.
Oh Allison, I have a ring if you kiss me.
Yes, these have all been very good questions, and we invite you to sit and ponder them until our next installment of The Lovely Literature Ladies. Until then, cheers!
Don't give up, Aurelius. I know a man.
Wait, did I say, hey Joe, you're back?
Hey man, or hey dude.
Yeah.
Up.
Hey dude, you're back. How's your trip?
Great.
No.
Oh no.
Sweet Allison. That's her name, right?
Yeah. Consider it done. What kind of plan would I
do? Really? I had it.
Check on him.
It's back.